मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर दिस ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन है कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड ब्लड एंड दिस गैसियस ट्रांसपोर्ट टेक्स प्लेस इन द ब्लड एंड टिश्यू टू डिस्कस टुडे ऑलरेडी यू हैव लर्नड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर अबाउट द एक्सचेंज ऑफ दिस गैसेस दैट इज ऑक्सीजन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड रिवाइजिंग सम पोर्शन ऑफ दैट लेक्चर What is the site for that gaseous exchange? Anybody can tell? That gaseous exchange takes place where it happens in the lung. What is the main site? That is the alveoli. Alveolar tissues are there in the lungs, which are responsible. Gases exchange between CO2 and O2. The oxygen we inhale comes to these alveolar tissues and then through the blood capillary, which is very close in proximity to the alveolar tissues membrane. These alveolar tissues they transfer the oxygen to the blood capillary. The high partial pressure of oxygen here inside the alveolar tissues. There is a low partial pressure inside the blood capillaries. There is a diffusion of partial pressure from the alveolar tissues to the blood capillaries. Then from blood capillaries, it is transported to different types of tissues where there is a requirement for oxygen. For generating energy, besides the waste material, carbon dioxide and water. This carbon dioxide has to be again reverse transported to alveolar tissues, to the blood capillary by diffusion and by partial pressure. It comes to the alveolar part again, and it is exhaled out of the body. The lung transport, how this transport occurs from the alveolar force which is transporting gases. This serves as a transport, the respiratory gases. The oxygen, which is essential for the cells, is transported from alveoli of lungs to the cells. Why it is essential? Because most of the cells, they need energy. Energy they are requiring, they mainly comes from aerobic oxidation. In the presence of oxygen, respiration occurs, which gives large amount of energy in comparison to anaerobic respiration. So most of the cells, they are restricted to aerobic respiration, producing energy in presence of oxygen. Only few cells like RBC and that muscle cells, they are restricted to anaerobic respiration. In this way, oxygen is transported. Like this way, while carbon dioxide is the waste product of this aerobic respiration generated in that cells besides ATP, is reverse transported from cells to the lungs in order to exhale out of the body. We are taking up the transport of oxygen. Oxygen, as I already mentioned, it already proved that it is transported from alveoli to the tissue by blood in two forms. The first one is in the form of simple physical solution that is dissolved in the plasma. It is only about 3% of oxygen. Very low, while most of the oxygen, that is 97%, it is transported when it combines with hemoglobin present in RBC. In the common, what percentage part of oxygen combined the water unit is 0.3 ml per 100 ml. That is why it is mentioned 3%. Only 3% of blood. It will give you poor solubility of oxygen in water content of plasma. Important point to be noted that during the exercise, this type of oxygen transport is usually occurs to meet the excess demand of oxygen by the tissue. This plasma mode of transport of oxygen, that is only 3% of the total oxygen dissolved, it is required during the exercise for the generation of energy inside the muscles. The most important part, the most important percentage, higher percentage of oxygen, 97%, it is combined to the hemoglobin in order to be transported to different tissues. So this oxygen combines with hemoglobin in blood and it is transported as oxyhemoglobin, the term given for oxygenated hemoglobin. What do you mean by oxygenation of hemoglobin? It is combination of oxygen and hemoglobin. That is why the term comes oxyhemoglobin. Important point again, it is noted that in the process of oxygenation and not oxidation, just nature of the hemoglobin is not changed. In the process of oxygenation, there is no change in the ferrous ions of hemoglobin. It is only change in oxidation. Oxygen can be released from hemoglobin when it is required. As the requirement and partial pressure. Where is this? In those tissues where they do demand for energy. Oxygen is dissociated from hemoglobin. It comes inside the tissues for that aerobic respiration, glycolysis, TCA cycle, and electron transport chain for the generation of ATP. This is the oxygen. Starting from alveolar tissues of lungs, both the parts of the blood that is dissolved in plasma, and the second part is combined with hemoglobin in the red blood cell. It is somewhat approximately 97% to 98%. The greater percentage of oxygen combining with hemoglobin from oxygenated hemoglobin HbO2 in the red blood cell, that is RBC, while it's 2 to 3% that is dissolved in plasma. Very low percentage of oxygen is dissolved in plasma for the transportation. That portals. And then they are built down. Dissociated from hemoglobin in order to perform function of aerobic respiration. Combines with the first reaction of the glycolysis in order to process for the TCS and electron transport formation of energy. Again, when it decomposes from hemoglobin, it
सर आपकी आवाज कट रही है.
टेस्टिंग बैक टू द प्लाज्मा. ओके थैंक यू. दिस मिशन अगेन my voice. Okay, this is the very important part describing the whole translation from our lungs to the different cells or tissues requiring energy. This is transferred from alveolar tissues to the red blood cell. The higher percentage, that is 97% to 98%, and the lower percentage, 2% to 3%, is all in plasma. The both are transported to other different types of cells requiring energy. So when they are transported to these cells, they are first broken down into the free form of oxygen and hemoglobin. Oxyhemoglobin is dissociated into hemoglobin and oxygen. Then again, oxygen is dissolved in plasma, and then it is transported to the different types of cells requiring energy. That is for cellular respiration. Is very important. How much molecules of oxygen can be carried out by hemoglobin? It is 4. Each hemoglobin can carry 4 oxygen molecules, while one RBC contains this much, 250 million hemoglobin molecules, so can carry 1 billion oxygen. It is correct. One hemoglobin molecule can carry 4 oxygen, and one RBC, since it contains 250 million hemoglobin molecules, so the total oxygen that can be carried out by one RBC, it is 1 billion oxygen. 250 into 4. Now 1 gram of hemoglobin can combine with 1.34 ml of oxygen, and 100 ml of blood contains 15 gram of hemoglobin, so total hemoglobin, that is the blood which contains oxygen, is 15 gram into 1.34, it is equal to 20 ml of oxygen. Clear? 1 gram of hemoglobin contains 1.34 ml of oxygen. So 100 ml of blood, since it contains 15 gram of hemoglobin, so how much oxygen is carried out by 100 ml of blood? It is 20 ml of oxygen. Most of the units are mentioned in that is like blood glucose per 100 ml or per dl. So it is the standard concentration which most of the blood parameters are expressed. Now the picture can be clear by this hemoglobin molecule structure. Already you have learned in the protein structure that it contains 4 polypeptide chains, alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1 and beta 2. That is the protein chain, the protein part of hemoglobin, that is globin chain. While the heme is cofactor for this protein, heme is composed of ferroprotopyrene ring. And in the center of this protopyrene ring, iron is available, which is the main site for binding oxygen. is clear from this figure how hemoglobin binds to the oxygen. Which part? It is the non-protein part which is responsible for binding to the oxygen, and that is iron part of heme. What is the oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin? As already previously mentioned, 1 gram of hemoglobin can carry 1.34 ml of oxygen. How can you define oxygen carrying capacity? It is the capacity of hemoglobin, that is the amount of oxygen transported by 1 gram of hemoglobin. Now it is about only 1 gram of hemoglobin carrying this much oxygen. Now what about the oxygen carrying capacity of blood? This refers to the amount of oxygen transported by the blood. Since the blood contains many RBCs and it has many heme groups, besides that iron, so normal hemoglobin content of blood is 15 gram percentage, and since oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin is 1.34 ml per gram, so blood with 15 gram percentage of hemoglobin should carry 1.34 into 15. On multiplication it comes 20 ml percentage of oxygen, approximately 20 ml. So this is the simplification phenomena, how 100 ml of blood it can carry 20.1 ml of oxygen. Been given to this oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin, it is 1.34 ml per 1 gram of hemoglobin, while oxygen carrying capacity of blood is 20.1 ml of oxygen.